Okay guys, so today's workout is a conditioning workout. And what the plan is we're gonna start with our normal warm-up, so basic warm-up, I'll lead it. We're gonna go for 8 to 10 minutes. Then we're gonna do some roll to squat mobility, just to open up the hips and just try our tricks a little bit. Our workout today is going to be pure body weight, pure speed, and you don't need any equipment other than I'm gonna be using two big thick books, otherwise you could use a plate. I'm gonna be jumping onto them, and I'll show you that later. What the workout is gonna be, the format is gonna be 20 seconds on and 10 seconds off. And we're gonna continue that for 16 minutes. So it's gonna start relatively comfortable, but you wanna push the pace. Every time you're on for those 20 seconds, that's a time that you can push hard, 10 seconds to catch your breath, then we move on to the next movement. So for example, we're gonna be doing 8 full minutes here and then moving straight into the second 8 minutes. First 8 minutes is going to be max reps on your squat. So you're gonna do 20 seconds of max squats, 10 seconds off, then we go straight into max reps of our book hops, kind of similar to skipping. Then we have 10 seconds off, that's one round. We're gonna do 8 rounds of that. So the second round, 20 seconds of squats, 10 second rest, straight into our book hops, that's 2 rounds done, then we move into the third round and so on for 8 rounds. Once we complete those 8 rounds, we're gonna immediately move into the next 2 movements, which are gonna be jumping lunges and tuck ups. Again, I'm gonna go over those movements later on, and then we'll kick it off in the workout. So to start now, we're just gonna jump straight into our warm up. So as always, we're gonna start with the feet together, and we're just gonna go for our close stand squats. So feet together, hands forward, 10 good reps, sitting down to the very, very bottom. 2, 10 reps, 3. Use this as mobility, go nice and slow, and work through them. 10. Next 10 are gonna be in a regular stance. We're gonna hold for 3 seconds at the bottom, still squats. So hit the bottom, hold, up, one, bottom, hold, up, 2, bottom, hold, up, 3, bottom, hold, up, 4, bottom, hold, up, 5, bottom, hold, up, 6, bottom, hold, 7, hold, up, 8, 2 more, at the bottom, and hold, up, 9, last one, bottom, hold, up, 10. Next, what we're going to do is a long lunge. So I'm going to be taking a big step back, hands to the side, then I'm going to put my hands down and just sink into that position for 2 seconds, and stand tall. Again, big step, to the side, touch the floor, and up. 10 reps, that's 2. Stay on the floor. We're just going to open up the back a little bit. So what I'm going to get you to do is just roll on the ball for 5 reps. Tuck it up. 5 reps. Little roll. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Advancing that slightly, I'm going to roll back, lift my hips up, and then roll forward into a hamstring stretch. So hips up, split the legs and roll through. 10 times. Just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. From there, we are going to get our 2 books that I said. So we need 2 thick books, otherwise 2 plates. Okay, say maybe a 10 or 15 kilo plate. From there, I'm gonna put one on the floor. I'm gonna use this as my ankle mobility. And the other one isn't like crucial to have, but I'm gonna use it as like a counterbalance for myself. So starting with my heels on the bottom plate or the bottom book, I'm gonna squat into the bottom position. Just leaning this forward allows me to bring my weight forward and stay in that bottom position, okay? From there, we're just gonna hold it for a couple of seconds, rocking side to side. Again, I've got my heels elevated and I'm just opening up my ankles and my knees. You're only using this to keep your balance if you need it. 5 more. From there, we're going to shift our weight a little, so you're sinking to one side. If you need to touch the floor, you can. We're going to lift one leg out, raise it if possible, and then change sides. We're going to do 10 reps. That's 1, 2, 3. If necessary, your heel can touch the floor, or you can even touch the floor as well. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, now we're gonna up that bottom position a little more. I'm gonna get you to put your hands under your toes. You kick back as far as you can, and then come right down to the bottom, lift your chest up. That's 1, just 5 reps. Kick back and hold, and bottom and up. 2, 8, and through, 3, 8, and through, 4, one more, 8, through, 5. Okay, so next one. You're gonna use one of your books as your counterbalance, okay? What we're gonna try to do is roll to squat here. So we're gonna be sitting back, lifting the hips, pushing the book forward, and landing in that bottom position. Let's go ahead and do 5 reps. Two more. If it's easy with the book, let's go no book. 4, 1 more, 5. Okay. So next piece I'm gonna do is start going over the movements that we're going to be doing in our workout. The first piece we are doing is our squats, and then we're going into our book hops, okay? So for your squats, all we're looking at doing is getting your hip below your knee. You have to hit the very bottom of this. There's no point doing short half reps. Your full reps are going to be standing feet shoulder apart, hands out in front, hitting the very bottom. So you'll see when I go down, my hip breaks that decrease, and I'm down in that bottom position. Okay, you've got to get hip underneath. That's where we're looking for. You can put your hands wherever you want, but it's more a little easier to keep them forward just to counterbalance your weight. Okay, so I'm going to be doing my squats like so, bringing my hands forward as I go down to counterbalance my weight and allowing me to sit right back. And as I stand, I'll bring them back in. So that's how we're going to do our squats. So let's go ahead and do 10 reps. Go. Seconds rest immediately into 20 seconds on of book hops, 10 seconds rest. That's one round done. We're going to roll through 8 rounds of that, so 8 minutes of that. Then we are going to go straight into the second piece. The second piece consists of jumping lunges and tuck ups. So let's go over them. Jumping lunges. You don't need any equipment for this piece. Your knee has to touch the floor. You got to get to the very bottom. You have to leave the floor before you change legs. It looks like knee to floor every time. Leave the floor every time. You have to jump and you have to open your hips. We can't be here. You've got to stand tall every time. So both legs and hips have to straighten. That's your jumping lunges. All right, let's go ahead and do 10 reps. Ready, go. Nine, 10. Okay, tuck ups, the final movement. This is the core movement. So on this one, we're gonna be on the floor. What the movement is you keep your feet off the ground. I'm gonna fully extend and then crunch in. So extend and crunch, extend and crunch. There are our tuck ups. To scale this movement, you're going to have your hands behind you. This to make it slightly easier. Lift your legs up, and we're doing short reps, nice and fast. Pick whatever option you think you can do, and let's go ahead and do 10 reps, okay? I'm going to do 5 with the harder one, and 5 with the easier one, just so you can see how they look. Ready, and go.
at scale version 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay.
All right. One more time, we are going to be going for 16 minutes straight through. The first 8 minutes are max squats with max book hops. The second 8 minutes are going to be jumping lunges and tuck ups. All right, take 30 seconds to set up. I'm going to go ahead and set the clock. It's going to be a 10 second countdown before we start, and the clock should beep.
Thank you. Let's go!
checking in. Keep checking in with all our workouts. Post some scores to Track2 Fitness. Let us know how you're getting on. Let us know how you're getting on with your challenges or your mobility, like our roll to squat. Oh, Lundo, very good. Good session.